Hey everyone, Psychriasin here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to draw a dragon. Now, I know there's a lot of different kinds of dragons out there. There's an eastern kind, which are more snake-like, and the western kind. Today I'm going to be showing you how to draw the western kind of dragon, and I'm going to be using a dragon very similar to the ones found in Skyrim. And the reason I really like the dragon designs from Skyrim is it seems they thought about it in a way that it could be a real creature based on the anatomy. So it has a lot in common with a bat, and you'll see as we go that it's going to be somewhat bat-like. So the first thing I want to do is start with just a center line. This is just going to represent, you know, roughly where the dragon's going to be. And now I'm going to start at the collar bones and just indicate where the shoulder is. So it's very relatable to a human in terms of anatomy, because, you know, bats are mammals, and if you're going to relate to a bat, then it's going to be relatable as well to any mammal, including humans. So I'm just going to start with a line defining where the shoulders go, and now I'm going to create a triangle. Now, I'm a huge fan of triangles in my drawings. If you've seen my, you know, how to draw male and female humans, then I use triangles a lot too. So I'm going to start with a triangle, and I'm keeping it, you know, fairly long like this. It's not that stretched. I could stretch it more. Yeah, let's go ahead and stretch it a bit more. So I'm just, you know, making it more narrow, so it appears more stretched, but you could go for fat too, you know, it's up to you, whatever you want. So okay, here we go. So now here's where the shoulders are going to be. All right, now keeping this in mind that this is where the shoulders go, we're going to draw the rest of the arm. So you have shoulder, and then it goes to an elbow, and do the same here, and then we're going to have the forearm. Now I want to keep the forearm pretty long like this, and here we have the hand. So I know it's a bit weird thinking in terms of, you know, elbows and shoulders and hands when we're drawing a dragon's wing, because this is going to be the wing. And this isn't the type of dragon where they have arms and wings and legs. It's that the arms themselves are the wings. And that's the same as, you know, bats. So thinking of this like a hand, it's going to be a bit like if you had a human hand and you had, you know, the thumb pointing out, and then the fingers out like so. So it's going to be something like this, but like the anatomy is going to be similar to this. Okay. So for the thumb, we're going to put that out, and I'm going to extend it, and it's going to have a claw at the end. And now for the other four fingers. So I'm going to just put in some lines. I'll get rid of this for where the fingers go. So there's one, two, three, four. And now at the elbow, I'm just going to give a bit of a protrusion as if the bone kind of comes out like this. So there we go. So that's one wing. And I can do the same on the other side real quick. So get the forearm there, hand, maybe this thumb is pointing down, and then get those four fingers in. One, two, three, 4. And note how they all come from this one point. And then the elbow. And actually, this is a bit off because I made this too long. So I'm just going to shrink that, get rid of this, get the thumb back in, and 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, and now for the neck and the head. So first I'm going to create another triangle. So we kind of have a diamond, kind of like a kite, right? And we can go ahead and even put in a center line there. And then I'm going to create a neck shape. And I'm just going to curve this to the end there. So if you want to overanalyze it, you know, maybe here's a center and then halfway through this triangle is the neck. And then I'm just going to kind of connect these two. So now we have a shape that's kind of triangle-ish, but, you know, goes into more of a straight view or like a rectangle that's bent. Okay, so we got that in. And now the head's going to go here. So for the head, I'm going to think of it like a diamond as well. Similar to the shape we had here. And it's going to fit, you know, it's a bit bigger than the width of this from here to here. This is going to be a bit bigger, but not a whole lot bigger. So just going to put that there. And now let's continue on to the rest. So we're going to have a pelvis area. I'm just going to put in a line for where the hips go. And I'm just going to start extending this triangle a bit. So, and I'll keep the hips, you know, fairly narrow compared to the shoulders, even though the shoulders are quite narrow as well. And I'm just gonna shrink this a bit so it all fits on the page. Maybe a bit more. Okay. And I'm gonna get the tail in. Now the tail's gonna be pretty long because it has to counterbalance all this weight up top. So have a long tail here, and you'll notice the wings are pretty large as well in proportion to you know, the length of the dragon. The width of the wings are almost, you know, just as wide as the length. And now that I have a bit more room, just gonna make the wings bit more spread out. In fact, I probably should have made more room for myself. You don't want to get caught, you know, stuck at the end of the page. Here we go. That in. And I'm keeping, just like a normal hand, I'm keeping some of the fingers longer than others. Okay, so we have this structure. I'm just going to put in the legs. And for the legs, they're fairly human-like, at least for the hips and the thighs, keeping it somewhat humanoid. But now it's going to change because we're going to have kind of like an animal leg. So I'm going to show it from the side view here. And what's going to happen is you'll get the thigh area. And then we'll have the knee, and then the calf is going to be, you know, pulled back, and then you'll have the heel and the foot comes out like this. So it's more like, you know, a wolf or a cat or any other animal like that. It's really balancing its weight on its toes instead of on, you know, the whole foot. And at the end, where the heel is, we can go ahead and add, you know, like a claw at the end back there. So I'm gonna get in where the knee would go, and I usually just block it in like this. And if you're familiar with my lightning bolt technique, it's similar to that. So just start with lines, same as what I did with the wings, just to indicate where things are going to be. And then I'm going to add a circle that's a bit fatter. It's like a flat oval like that. And that's just telling me, you know, where the toes are going to be. And now I'm going to create circles, three of them here. Do that there, create three circles. And now I'm going to add lines spreading out, and then I'm going to add another circle and another circle. So we've got some circles and some smaller circles. Just going to go ahead and put those in. So each circle is a bit smaller than the one before. And these are going to represent the knuckles. And just want to make sure that the middle one is longer than the outer ones. So do that here as well. And pretty much this is it. Like, now we have the basic skeleton of our dragon. And now I'm going to go into the detail phase.